That is so cool. It's like X-ray vision. You can see the engine inside the case. You think it's getting too hot in there?
Noise reduction boxes like these can make a generator run much more quiet. But will it make a generator run too hot? Today, we're going to try to answer those questions by testing oil temperature and the temperature inside the box. The generator that we're using today for our testing is the Predator 3500 from Harbor Freight. To get a baseline, we're going to run the generator all by itself for an hour, and we're going to use the camper's AC. Slinging the camera today, we have Fred Jr. and Ann. Let me show you some thermal imaging of all three of the sound boxes with the FLIR 1 and my iPhone. All right, our generator's been running for a little over an hour. Our Bluetooth sensor is saying 80 degrees, and our oil temperature is right at 208. Now we have this thing running with a full load because the air conditioner is on in the camper. Next, let's put on a sound box. We'll start with the OSB plywood.
You think it's getting too hot in there?
Oh, wait a minute. No, it's just the Bluetooth. There, now we're connected. And let's let it run for 30 minutes. All right, we've been running for 30 minutes and our Bluetooth temperature is 85 degrees inside the box and the oil temperature peaked at 237 degrees. Now, it's an 80 degree day today, so that's with the wooden box. Let's switch over to the styrofoam. See you in 30 minutes. When I installed the dryer vent, I actually broke it and I thought it would be just fine, but it turns out it's not. So I need to put a new dryer vent on there because it's melted my styrofoam. Another 30 minutes of runtime, this time with the styrofoam sound box. Inside of this box, our Bluetooth temperature is also 85 degrees, and it looks like the oil temperature has peaked at 244 degrees Fahrenheit. Next up is the sound shed. See you in 30 minutes. All right, it's been 30 minutes. Our outside air temperature is now up to 85 degrees. Let's talk about the numbers inside the sound shed. So the Bluetooth in there, 87 degrees. That's 2 degrees warmer than the others, but we don't have a fan blowing in there. And our oil temperature peaked at 239, and it's operating right now at about 230. Now I'll pull off the sound shed and we'll get a second baseline after it's been running for all this time. All right, our ending baseline numbers, our ambient temperature with the Bluetooth is 88 degrees in the shade. Our low oil temperature is 232, and our high peak was 241. We've let it run for 30 minutes, and this generator, it's been running for 3 hours. Let's crunch some of the numbers. With the Bluetooth, we were 85 degrees inside the wooden box. Inside the styrofoam box, we were also 85 degrees. Inside the sound shed, 87 degrees, so 2 degrees warmer. Let's talk about the oil temperatures. The oil temperature peak for the wooden sound box was 237. The low was 225. This box here was 244 for a peak on the oil temperature, and the low was 230. Our winner back there was the sound shed. Oil temperatures peaked at 239, and the low was only 219. The instruments that we used for our testing today were a meat thermometer, an Inkbird Bluetooth thermometer, and the FLIR 1 thermal imaging camera. The meat thermometer, Fred Jr. modified. We took an old dipstick and he drilled a hole in it and some RTV sealer and away we went. At no point in today's testing did we trigger the thermal shutdown for the generator. Is using a generator noise reduction sound box safe? I say yes. Normal oil temperature for a generator is between 230 and 260 for conventional oil. We use full synthetic and according to Motor Trend, it'll go up to 300. We didn't get anywhere near that. The winner of our little competition today was the sound shed. This thing kept the generator the coolest and it kept the oil temperature the coolest. There's no fan, it only weighs 10 pounds, and this thing was pretty easy to make. I made an entire video on the build for this, and I'll put a link to that right here. I'm glad you watched, and I hope you'll watch again.
That is so cool. It's like X-ray vision. You can see the engine inside the case. And look at the exhaust on the ground.